Hey guys, welcome to today's class. In the past class, we have learned about variables, the Python syntax, and you know how Python basically interprets code line by line. In today's class, we are going to be talking about operators. What are operators? Operators are nothing but tools that help you perform an operation on one or more data points. These data points can also be called as operands. To give you a very simple example of operators, if you remember your childhood, you had a lot of mathematical operators. The addition, the subtraction, the division, the multiplication, all these were operators. So let's start with mathematical operators first. Let me just share my screen with you. Let me start with the addition operator. I'll just remove the previous class code. So to simply, you know, use the addition operation, it's very simple. Just the way you would do in mathematics in your childhood, you can do it over here. You can write x is equal to 2 plus 5. And what would x store now is the value of 2 plus 5. Let's just try it out first before I further explain this code. What I'm doing is I'm just saving the value of 2 plus 5 in x and I'm printing it out right now over here. And when I do it, when I print it out, you will see over here we get 7 as the output. Now what is happening over here is, first of all, what you have done is you have said x. You have told Python that you are declaring a variable, you know, and you have put an equal to by, you know. And then what you have done over here is basically you have put in the usual mathematical code that you would write in your mathematics class. You write 2 plus 5 over here. Now what happens over here is in Python, everything that is out, you know, on the right side of equal to will get first evaluated. It will get evaluated first, and whatever is the outcome, you know, will be stored in x. Okay, so what is happening over here is this can, you know, whatever is on the right side can also be called as an expression. In Python, you know, a group of operators that are present together in a single line can also be called as an expression. In this expression, what is happening is, you know, we are asking the Python interpreter to basically add up two numbers. So in this case, what will happen is, first of all, this entire thing will get evaluated and this value will be stored in x. And the next line, what we are doing is we are simply asking it to, you know, print the value of whatever is in x. Instead of storing it first in x, we can also, you know, pass it on directly to the print function. What is happening over here is when we are saying print 2 plus 5. And as you will see over here, we'll get the same output even now, 7. What is happening over here is basically, first of all, this expression will get evaluated. And whatever its value is comes out to be, it will get passed to the print function as a parameter. If you remember functions, you remember that they have parameters which the function takes in and, you know, use it to perform some action. If you would have noticed something over here, that in this case, we provided space, okay, 2 plus 5. But over here, we did not provide any space. So when you are, you know, using plus to separate out or using an operator between two numbers, what is going to happen is the Python interpreter does not care about space. You can add as many space as you want, or you can also not have space. The Python interpreter immediately understands that, you know, you are trying to basically use the plus operator between what is on the left side of it, the left operand and the right operand. So it can also be called as the first operand and the second operand. So Python understands this and basically, you know, adds this up without, you know, worrying about space. The way we have used plus operator, we can also use, you know, the subtraction operator. And what we'll get as a result over here is minus 3. And remember, you know, in Python, you can store negative numbers as well. So negative numbers, zeros, floating, decimal, all of these will work. Now, what if we want to multiply, you know, instead of adding? So what I'll do is I'll, you know, just create some separate lines to show this. So we can also multiply things. Let me just, you know, first write out the division command. Then we can also write about multiplication. What if I want to multiply 2 by 5? You need to use something called as a star operator, which stands for multiplication in the world of programming. So if you can see over here, you will get 10. Now what if we want to divide? Can we divide? Definitely. Python, you can also divide. We can simply use 10 divided by 5 and we'll get the outcome as 2. Now those who are coming from, you know, other languages like Java, they might be surprised at, you know, seeing that Python by default produces decimal point as the output for division, which is the case that we happen, you know, happens in the real world. For example, if we divide, instead of 10 by 2, if I do 5 by 2, it will give me the correct output as 2.5. In some other languages, what happens is, you know, the Python operator, the division operator, it will get truncated and you will get only the integer part. To do so in Python, you need to use double slash, which is basically used to, you know, produce only the truncated part of the division operator. You might use either of this or the single operator. The single division operator will give you the accurate result in floating point. But the double, it will truncate things out for you and it will give you only two. Right now we have used single operator, single division operator, and we are getting the accurate result even in floating point. There are two more mathematical operators, and one of them you are going to use extensively while doing data searches and algorithm. The one is basically the remainder operator. That is, you know, what remainder would you get when you divide a number by another number? So instead of writing print 5 by 2, I would want to know what would be the remainder when I divide 5 by 2. And we use percentage operator for that. In this case, we'll get the remainder when we divide a number by another number. So as you can see over here, the remainder over here is 1. What if we tried, let's say, 5 divided by 3? We should get the remainder as 2. And that would be the case over here. So that's basically the remainder operator. The remainder operator or the modulus operator is going to be very, very important and especially useful when you want to check whether a number is divisible by another number completely or not. So in that case, you can compare it with zero, and that is something that we'll be talking about when we talk about comparison operators. Another operator that is very important and is the exponential operator. That is when you want to use the power, or which is also called as the power operator in mathematics. So if you want to raise 2 to the power of 4, what you need to do is exponential operator. So for that we have got double star. So in this case, if you see over here, basically you have got a single star which is used to represent mathematical multiplication. But if you want to use the exponential operator, you have to use 2 double stars over here. And remember, these stars are very important to be put together. If you put in a space over here, you will get an error. Let's just try it out and you will see that there's an error over here. So in this case, it's very important to put these 2 stars together. Python understands that you're talking about the exponential operator. And what it will do is it will perform, you know, it will take the left operand and raise it to the power of the right operand. This operand can also be performed on decimal numbers as well. So let's just try it out on 4.3. What if we raise 2 to the power 4.3? And as you can see over here, we have got a result. We can also, you know, raise decimal numbers to the power of decimal numbers, and we'll still get, you know, the right answers. So far we have used operators only on numbers. Can they be also used on variables, which are basically store of data? Yes. If you remember, variables have got two purposes. One is they can store data, and the other is we can retrieve that data and use it somewhere. So if you want to perform operation on variables, that can also be done. So let me just add a line over here to distinguish between, you know, the lines below and the lines that we are going to write here. What I'm doing is I'm just adding a string so that it becomes visually clear that we are talking about the part above this versus the part below this. So it's just a string over here. Now, so far we have just printed out x, and what is happening over here is x has stored what is the value of 2 plus 5. It has stored in it. And now when we print it out, we can get it. We can also print out, you know, x minus 2. And we'll get the result as 5. In this case, what is happening is when we have said x minus 2, the Python interpreter immediately rushes back, brings the value of, you know, x, whatever is stored in x, and it subtracts it with 2. And it will give the output whatever we get. In this entire duration, nothing is happening to x. Whatever its value was stored inside it, it is remaining intact. Same way, we can also perform other operations. We can also, you know, perform x plus 2 over here. And when we do it, we'll get the result as 9. We can also perform operators, you know, we can also perform the operations on multiple variables or numbers. So for example, instead of saying, you know, x is equal to 2 plus 5, I'll also define a variable which will store 5. And instead of writing x minus 2, I'll write x minus 5. And this is equally valid. And as you can see, the output is still same, that is 2. If I change the value of y as, you know, 3, it will work same. Just to remember this, you know, this important thing, that in either of these cases, the values of x and y are remaining unaffected. That is, we have just fetched a copy of those values and are using them to perform the operations, but the values are stored as it is. Whatever the output we are getting of this expression, we are getting it, and we can save it in some other variables also. For example, instead of writing like this, we can write z is equal to x plus y. Now z will house the value of whatever is x plus y, and if we print this out, you can see over here, we'll get 10 as the output. In this case, what is happening over here is when the Python interpreter sees that, you know, you are writing z is equal to x plus y. It immediately understands that z is a variable. It will just, you know, and you are trying to save something in it. What are you trying to save in it? First, it will evaluate, because it's an expression. It will get evaluated first. It will see that you are writing x plus y. What it understands is you are trying to add the value of x with the value of y. It will go, it will retrieve both their values and add it, and whatever the result is, it will save it in z. And that is why we'll get the output as 10. One question that might come in your mind at this moment is, you know, can I perform an operation on a variable and save it back inside it? For example, can I, you know, multiply whatever the value of x is and save it back inside it? So definitely, yes, you can do that also. And to do that, just think about how you would do it. Just pause the video for a second and reply in the comment box as well how you would do it. So to do it, you will simply write how you would write other places. And for example, if you want to multiply z by 2, what you will do is you will write z is equal to z into 2. And as you will see over here, the output is 20. Now what is happening over here is, when you've written z is equal to z into 2, the Python interpreter will come, it will see, okay, so you want to save something in z, okay. What you want to save, it will see this and it will evaluate it. In this case, what will happen is, it will go and fetch the value of z, which is basically 10. It will multiply it by 2. It will keep the result and it will see that you want to save it back in z. And it will simply save it back in z. So whatever the value of z was, it will be replaced. The operation that is happening over here, the order that is being followed over here is, first this is getting evaluated. So far the value of z that was there in the, you know, memory is 10. And that is why when it gets evaluated, it will get 10 into 2. And now this value that we have gotten new will be saved in the same variable again. So the Python interpreter will go and it will replace whatever was there in the z variable and it will save 20 inside it. One natural question that should come in your mind right now is, you know, in case of real world, instead of writing just, you know, two operators, you can also you know, write, for example, 5 plus 6. So you can write basically 4 or 5 operands and, you know, perform operations on them. Can we do that in Python? Definitely yes. So if you see over here, and if I, you know, do it over here, we'll see 42. Let me just remove this line, or let me just print z before this. And in this case, as you will see over here, in the first line, we are printing the value of whatever we are getting over here. You will get the output as 21, because we are simply adding, you know, 2x plus y plus 5 plus 6. Now, what is the order? If I can do plus, can I also do subtraction? Yes, you can do that also. Same way, can I do multiplication also? Yes, you can also add a multiplication operator here. Now, you must be wondering, what is the order? You know, what order are we going to follow? You know, which operator will get applied first? So if you remember your childhood days, you had a rule called BODMAS in mathematics that says bracket, then division, then multiplication, then basically it says, you know, subtraction and addition. So subtraction, addition take the same precedence. The same order is followed even in the world of programming. So brackets will come first. We learn how to use brackets in, you know, an expression right now. But before this, in this case, what will happen is, just to make things easier for you, what I'm going to do is, instead of x or y, I'm going to replace with their original values, that is 7 and 3. And what we'll get is the same output. Now in this case, what will happen is, by our BODMAS rule, it will go and evaluate this expression. It will see whether there's a bracket. There's no bracket, so it will move on. It will see whether there are any division operators. And it will find division operators. No, none are there. So it will move on to multiplication. At C's, there's a multiplication. So it will multiply 5 into 6 first. It will save 30 over here. Then it will perform addition operator. In this case, 7 plus 3, 10. And then it will perform division operator. So 10 minus 30 is equal to minus 20. And that is how you will get the result. Let me just revert it back to its original position. But if we want to, you know, change the precedence of this order, what do we need to do? We just need to add brackets over here. So for example, instead of saying, you know, 7 plus 3 minus 5 into 6, in this case, by default, 5 into 6 will be there. If we add a bracket, for example, over here, whatever is inside the bracket will get evaluated first, again, by following the BODMAS principle. And then, and only then, you know, the multiplication operator will come in. I can also put in nested brackets, like how would you do in the world of mathematics. Same, we can do it over here also. So instead of writing bracket, we can also, inside bracket also, we'll write bracket. And the same precedence order will be followed within the brackets also. So BODMAS goes inside the bracket, it will follow the BODMAS order over there also, and then it will evaluate the complete expression. So far we have learned about mathematical operators. Next, we'll also learn about conditional operators, we'll learn about Boolean operators, we'll also learn about assignment operators. But before moving to that, I want to give you some assignment. And for doing those assignments, you need to know how to use functions. So in the next class, first we'll be talking about functions, and I'll also give you some homework assignment so that you can practice and evaluate whether the code you are writing is correct or not. If you like this video, please make it a point to subscribe, like, and share with your friends. Hope to see you in next class. Goodbye.